Life is full of mystery. Everywhere you look, in plain view, enigmas are being created. Those enigmas have names. Some are the miraculous transformations that take place when two people become one. This is called love. Some are the peculiar happenstances when one can no longer recall just what it was they intended. The lost. However, some are a bit more sinister. The times when some puzzles are best left unsolved, when the answer best not known, these are called crime. That's where I come in. Me, T. Baxter, private investigator. As someone who has been in the business for a while, I've seen the underbelly of humanity, the things you cannot talk about with civil society.
Morning.
Morning.
Ain't that old man you, Holtz Rig?
Yes, he's my uncle. I'd like a side of salt meat, 10 pounds of sugar, 5 pounds of coffee, some baking soda, and a bathtub.
All right, mister.
What humanity will do when there's a possibility of getting away with it.
Where are your police? Have you no laws in this godforsaken country?
Si, senorita, we have laws. And men to break them.
I get a lot of customers coming through these doors. But looking back, none so peculiar as the one who visited that night. I was sitting in the office, minding my own affairs, when a young gentleman by the name of Cody notified me of a situation. Someone was missing.
Hello.
Mr. Malone, I see that you're in need of some assistance. It just so happens that I'm a PI. How can I help you?
What?
Private investigator. Could you answer some questions for me about Miss Pelt?
Sure.
When was the last time you saw Miss Pelt?
I think I saw it in the living room. Maybe in the lounge. I'm not exactly sure.
Was there a break-in?
No. It's been a long winter, and since we were having a sunny spell, I decided to do some cleanup. Now that I think about it, I had everything in the hallway, including old Sandy. That's his name, you see. But when I put everything back in the apartment, it was missing.
Is there anyone you know who would want to take Miss Pelt?
Well, the floor above us is known for its animal history. I heard one guy, Butch I think his name is, skins as a hobby.
Skins?
Yeah, he's pretty serious about it. I've been told he's got a pretty substantial collection. Listen, I don't know if it's him, but it's been missing for a week now, so it would be great if you could return it sooner rather than later. My brothers are getting irritated, and since I'm the only one there was when it was stolen, they're holding me responsible.
Time is of the essence. I'll get right on that. But, Mr. Malone, before I go...
Yes?
I don't know if you were raised by a pack of wolves, but women are not objects. And I'm sure Miss Pelt would appreciate it if you didn't address her as such. Good day, sir. Butch, is it?
Yeah? Who are you?
T. Baxter. P.I. I'm told your profession of choice is skin.
Well, I'd like to keep that on the down low, but, That's true, but business is business.
I hate to be so forward, but I don't have any time to waste. Where were you on the night of January 28th?
I was out with some of my boys. We got some tickets to go down to the races, see some horses run.
Will these boys be able to vouch for you?
I'm not so sure. They were in town to visit, but, they went back home.
Will anyone else be able to vouch for you?
Actually, there's the old lady downstairs. She's a little kooky, if you know what I mean, but she fancies a good skin every now and again. Says it makes her feel younger. She invited me to eat with her before we went out to the races.
One last thing before I go. Does the name Sandy Pelt ring any bell?
Listen, pal, I run into a lot of Sandy Pelts in my business, but it's all part of the job description.
If you recall anything, please let me know. ASAP.
nice to have a man in the house again. It used to be that they would wait in the parlor for me all day. But it's been a little scarce since they passed on.
Passed on, you say?
Yes. Dead. Every single one of them.
May I inquire as to how?
Have you ever heard of death, my lover? Actually, they all left me for other women. I have no idea where they are now. Except one, that is.
I see. What did you say your name was?
Oh, it's Colette, after the novelist.
Have you heard of Sandy Pelt?
Sandy Pelt? I vaguely recall something of that nature. Reminds me of that chippy who stole away with the one man I ever loved. She wouldn't even let me attend the funeral after he died. Though, in the end, she got what was coming to her.
Miss Colette, please think carefully. Are you sure you've never heard of Sandy Pelt?
I like pelts. They're soft. And fashionable, too. Hugh said he would get me a pelt just like Sandy's.
Is it true that you had dinner with Butch on January 28th?
Butch is supposed to get me my fur. I had to sell mine, but for a moment, I found it, though. I found it! Fur, Sandy's fur. Hold on.
Palooka, just get out. This is my stuff. Don't touch. Don't.
Why don't you just get out of here? I already got one kook in my life. I don't need another one snooping around.
You mean Miss Colette?
Yeah. I see you met her, haven't you? You're a persistent one, aren't you?
I visited her after you said she could verify your whereabouts. But her lack of sanity makes her witness invalid. All she could do was keep talking about her past affairs and sing some song about murder.
Listen, that's not my problem, bud. So why don't you just get out of here? I got a business to run, I got a bird to go see, so just leave me alone.
And there it was, my only real lead, lost. Sandy Pelt was out there waiting to be rescued, and I had no idea where to begin. I was back to square one.
To be honest, not too hot. It would help if you could give me some more information on Miss Pelt.
I've been meaning to ask you that. You said Miss Pelt on the phone, too. Why do you keep on saying that?
Well, Mr. Cody, as I mentioned before, I believe women should be addressed properly, with respect.
Mr. Baxter, Sandy Pelt is not a person. It's a fur pelt.
A fur pelt?
Yes.
If it's just a fur pelt, why did you put an ad in the paper?
After my great-grandma, Sonali, passed as the only living relative in the area, my brothers and I were responsible for cleaning up her place. My mother came back and told us that she wanted to keep the fur pelt in the family. We looked around and tried to find the pelt that we had sold, and we couldn't find it. One day, I was in a pawn shop, and I was looking for a cheap trinket for my girl. And when I saw the pelt, I bought it and brought it home and placed it on the shelf, and only had it for a day before it went missing. I think it was stolen. I hear coyote pelts are a pretty rare find in the city.
I see. Wait, a coyote pelt?
Yes. We named it Sandy, after my great-grandma.
Sandy? How did she pass?
The strangest thing. At first we thought of age, but the doc said poison. We figured she just couldn't live without my great-grandpa Hugh. He died just last year, and she passed not 2 months after.
Hugh? Collect! Call the police!
Come in!
Oh, Miss Collette. You look pretty as a picture with your hair all done up like that.
Oh, Hugh, you're too kind.
I've got you a gift. Would you like me to put it on you?
Oh, Hugh, you shouldn't have. What will Sandy say?
Oh, Sandy. You know I only married her for her money. You're the only one for me, doll.
Stop right there! Fellas, arrest that man for the attempted murder of that woman, and that woman for the murder of Sandy Malone.
What are you talking about?
It all makes sense now. Collette, you had an affair with Sandy's husband, and after he died, resented her for not allowing you to go to his funeral. So, filled with grief and rage, you killed her. After killing her, you remembered the pelt Hugh promised, and you decided to steal Sandy's. Only after you sold it did you realize it had something more valuable than a coyote pelt. You immediately went back for the pelt. But it was too late. It drove you mad, knowing you'd lost something so priceless. Fur. Sandy's fur. Holds a little secret treasure. Murder. You knew what she did. And that Cody had just purchased that coyote pelt. When you saw it in the hallway, you couldn't resist the thought of making some extra cash. So you stole it. You knew that you'd be suspect. So you had your boys take it with them back home. Then, you had them ship it back to you once the heat was off. You knew Collette was a ticking time bomb. So you had to get rid of her. I'm sure if you check in Butch's room, you'll find the pelt and the pin.
I think you were right, Detective. The pelt and the pin were found in Butch's apartment. Good work.
Mr. Baxter, you not only found the pelt, you solved my great aunt's mystery death.
All in a haze.
Yes, there is mystery all around us, and some mysteries will never be solved. But for the few times when the pieces fit together, when we can discover the truth and reveal justice, those are the moments I live for. Me, T. Baxter, P.I.
Well, I really think one of us should go up and say goodbye to her. You know, since we're leaving so early in the morning.
Yeah, well, the trouble is, I'm occupied.
Yes, right.
You want to buy me a drink, and then I'll have to buy them one, and it may turn out to be a long evening.
Well, look, I'll tell you what. What say I go up there, and I'll say goodbye for both of us.
Oh, buddy, I knew you'd see it my way.
Don't mention it.